Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Dislyte on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Dislyte and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Dislyte. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, to start we have to launch our main browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen. You don't need to type it, simply because I added the clickable link in the video description and the first pinned comment. We landed at this point on our own website of Usitility, at which we include a precise explanation on how you can download and install Dislyte on laptop or computer. We scroll lower a tad and click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we arrive here on the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will launch to enjoy the game Dislyte on our PC. It is now obvious that we get a great deal of pros of running the emulator. Now we are on the way to start downloading the Dislyte by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. Next step is clicking on that button. And the download takes no time at all. Here it is. Here is located the download. It is an executable file. What we are going to do now is to run the installer, so we have to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the web browser to start to see the installer considerably better. The installer is pretty simple. It is made up of two possibilities, install and setup path. I will show you what setup path really does. We just simply click on it. And now we realize that they got here the path where in fact the emulator can be placed. If we choose to change this directory we have got to click on that browse option, so we opt for another directory and install the emulator wherever we would like. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. I simply click on back. So I just click on install. Voila! The install commences and it will go forward along with the download of those megabytes which are shown on our computer screen. At the time you save it on your machine, it could be more or less megabytes. The download speed can be faster or slower, subject to your type of connection and according to the velocity of the emulator servers. Now they are going quite fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator has actually been started automatically. As you can observe, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will move forward to the right then when it attains the end, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. The truth is the emulator has been started, here it is for the very first time. Before we carry on, as now you can see, it created two app icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is definitely the only one we're focused on. Anytime we would like to operate Dislyte on our desktop or laptop, we double mouse click on this particular software icon and consequently run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Why don't we conduct the next phase, which is a must-have, and which is to log on to the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you can observe the Google Play is presented. At this point we have to log on. At this point once we're here, we must absolutely conduct this next step that is imperative. Therefore just click on, Sign In. At this moment it announces, Checking Info. It might sometimes get stopped at Checking Info, additionally it isn't going to move ahead. If that's the case, you may attempt to log in after a number of hours and it will surely quite likely be repaired. At this moment we can provide our email and password. The email address ought to be a Gmail email and its matching password. As an example you could use the very same email you are using at this time in your YouTube account. So I will provide my information and I'll go back immediately after I have done it. That's it, info typed. Here is Google welcoming us and presenting us their twos. We will approve them all by just pressing, I agree. Following, it allow us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can keep it selected, it's going to produce a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. Google Play Store is started without need to open it manually and automatically. To set up the video game, we have got to go to the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking on the app icon designated green colored. Right now that we are discovering the desktop of that emulator, we can see that we have now right here the install video game button. We then click on this button. There we come with the Android game. So let's then click right here on the install link that I'm displaying now in green color. And this will launch the software setup. At this moment it is going to install the game, it will take quite some time or perhaps it may just be amazingly quickly. It again all relies upon on our connection to the internet. It has by then completed installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this specific button I'm showing in green, so that you can launch Dislyte for the first time. We're presently on the emulator desktop, and we're on the way to simply click that new Dislyte app icon that was provided. This game app is started for the first time. Here we end up with it. I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should talk about the sound level of the emulator. This is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we do not use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of your emulator. And to appreciate the experience to the greatest, we can activate the large monitor, for which we have two options. This is simply the very first one. We mouse click on that app icon which I'm identifying in green color. And the display screen is maximized, experiencing one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In the event that we choose to play the game using all the screen, we click this particular app icon. And we'd presently be enjoying the gameplay in 100% screen setting. To leave the 100% screen functionality, just click the F11 key. Then we would definitely currently be in standard display setting. At present, I am on the way to explain you the keyboard mapping and that is definitely quite appealing. This strategy we definitely will be in a position to operate the game application much more easily. The very first thing is to press this app icon. And here you will have the ability to complete the necessary setups. I can put the default configuration, though if you intend to adjust that, you may very well achieve it without any problem. Obviously, the emulator is fully in our own language. Sometimes it occurs that your emulator is started in the wrong language, as an example, in Japanese. And therefore to set it up in the appropriate language we click here to the cogwheel. Then right here throughout other configuration settings, we click the language drop down. We should decide on the language we prefer, Italian, Mandarin, and so on. After the language is determined, we should save, the emulator would restart, and the game application, the next time we run it, will of course be in the specified language. At this point, you can find another thing that we must take into consideration, and this is that we will get a message from Gmail telling that a completely new electronic device has been associated with our own Google account. It will likely ask us if we are the people who have connected that electronic device. Of course, we must not get worried, simply because the emulator is behaving like an Android device. In order to determine which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we visit right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And so we browse here to the model selection. And here we learn that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for our tutorial. I hope that you appreciated it, specifically that you found it informative. If that is so, allow it a superb thumb up, subscribe, and any remarks, questions or ideas, let them in the comment field down below. You could even comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams from time to time, you get it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click on any of those instructional videos that happens to be showing up on the listing of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the following video tutorials. Bye.